Thank you so much for staying with us. We've been talking about the crisis rocking the APC, and the party's Deputy National Publicity Secretary, Mr. Timmy Frank, has been talking to us on the matter. Well, you said what we are seeing is perhaps just a little out of what may eventually cascade in the coming days in the party. Some people have said this party will probably split into three. It's looking so much, isn't it?
Well, one thing I want to let you know, first of all, I'm a very committed and loyal member of this party. And as a loyal member of this party, being a young man, I have to set a space. My idea today is to make the difference, to see how we can have one united party. It's only one united party that can bring us to save Nigeria.
So the APC is not united right now?
As of today, there are issues in this party.
What are the issues?
The way, the manner of way, I've made it clearly times without number. We need to tackle issues that bothers Nigerians, issues that bother party members. Let me tell you, Sheung, 6 months down the drain, after the last NEC meeting we held, there are so many issues we raised in that meeting. Up to today, none of them has been implemented.
What are some of these issues?
One, we talked about, you know, the issue of constituting the issue of BOT. We said, okay, it's either we're going to call it something Elders Council or BOT and some, but we agreed that we are going to put that in place. Secondly, one meeting has not been held after that last meeting. Not leadership meeting, not caucus meeting, not NEC meeting. For God's sake, there are critical issues. There are crises everywhere.
Is it the leadership of Oyeguna is weak, or the party is not getting itself together? Because a lot of people will say the APC was not ready for government.
We were ready for government, but apparently, I think, so far as I'm concerned, maybe the man that we have as chairman has not been able to put us together. He has not been able to unite us together. Neither has caused more division. Let me take you back. Look at the case of the National Assembly when we started. Tell me on what grounds that the national chairman allowed that thing called mock primaries as at that time. That is where the problem started. When we went into that mock primaries, there was no need for that. So when that thing started, that was where the crisis, I foresee danger in this party. And I start speaking out. When I was speaking out, nobody listened to me. But I want to tell you something, Sheung. It's very critical that we must go back to our drawing board. If we want this party to succeed, if we want this party to be one party, if we want this party to be united to fight in 2019.
What would be the drawing board for the APC?
The drawing board as of today, we have to go back to see that Oyegun has to step aside as a chairman.
And because that process is going to be strenuous, because the only way he can step aside if he resigns, or you go to a NEC meeting and it's probably an election.
Let me tell you, Sheung, today, if today, as party faithful and loyal people, if we said, okay, that's what, ask me the reason why is Oyegun not calling for NEC meeting at this point.
Why?
Because he knows the way the party is running as of today. If there is NEC meeting, Sheung, I bet you will pass vote of no confidence on the chairman.
Really?
Yes, because look at the crisis rocking. Let me set just little but few for you, Sheung. Today in this party, there is crisis rocking my own state. Let me set an example. The Bayelsa where I come from, there is crisis in the party. Go to Delta State, there is crisis in the party. Go to Kano State, there is crisis in the party. Go to Kaduna, there is crisis in this party. You know, so there is crisis almost in majority of...
Including
in those states as of today, there is crisis. So the party, we need a chairman that can unite us. We need a chairman that can be firm with his decisions.
What do you see as that man that can unite your party?
Well, when Oyegun goes, we'll decide that from the region where he comes from. Because I bet you the chairman still has to come from the South-South zone. So at that time, we are going to decide as South-South people to present somebody from that zone that can represent us very well.
And you can't see anybody right now?
There are people, but this is not something I should expose before the public right now. When we get to that bridge, we'll cross it. But
a lot of people will perhaps think it's because some people who want to be chairman are working against Chief Oyegun. That's why
nobody is working towards Chief Oyegun. Nobody's working towards it.
All right, let's look at what Tinubu said. His media office wrote on behalf of the former Lagos governor, and take a look at what the APC leader says. He says, at a portion of the statement from the Tinubu media office, I quote now, Oyegun has done the irredeemable. His coup is an insult to party and to patriot, to reason and to the reform agenda of this government. To remain silent will be to admit the defeat of the reform and progressive change many have labored to bring forth. While the forces resistant to change and reform are strong, Tinubu dare not submit to them. Tinubu encourages all party members not to submit to them. If we acquiesce in this wrong, the one greater than this shall cascade upon us. Well, that is from Chief Bola Tinubu. But with all of these, one would be wondering, it looks like some people are not on the same page. Even some of your leaders in the party, it's not only the chairman that has not agreed with some other people. Some people have not even agreed with themselves. The jostle for the chairmanship of the BOT or the Elders Council, also that is also in a contest. It looks so much that the party came together on a basis, some people said, it's just to win an election. And now that you have won election, you're really shaken by the quest to govern.
Shiun, that is not true. The truth is, we have internal issues. These internal issues, until we resolve, and look, let me tell you, now that some of us are saying that Oyegun should step aside, nobody wants to, see a clear picture of what is about to happen. Let me set one example to you. During our days in the PDP, when we were shouting that the then PDP government should, drop Bamanga Tuku, as a party, we complained, we make so much complaint to the then president, Goodluck Jonathan, that drop Bamanga Tuku, times to that number, that this man can't take this party to where we want this party to go. Then Jonathan refused to listen. That is the same scenario that is happening today in the APC.
Right.
Some of us are shouting today, Oyegun should leave. The leader, some persons are not seeing that picture. Until the danger comes at where, if we are not careful, the same scenario that happened in the PDP will happen again in
the APC. Let's
round up
this conversation now. Let's look at the issue of governance.
Yeah.
Now, the party wants to, the party said it wants to fight corruption with President Muhammadu Buhari as its leader. He says he wants to welfareism. A lot of issues that the party brought forward. Is the party achieving this? Is he on course?
Well, I can tell you, yes, the party, the president truly has demonstrated that he's a president that wants to truly fight corruption. And as a party, I think we are going to give him all the support he needs to fight corruption. And so far, so good. I think, that is being put in place. And so I can tell you clearly the government is doing so much, in the case of fighting corruption.
And it's not one-sided from your own point of view?
So far as I'm concerned, the most important thing is for us to get it right. If we do not get it right, then there is a problem, I understand today there are so many Nigerians that are saying the war against corruption is one-sided and so forth. Yes, again, I believe, the president should be fair to all Nigerians, And despite party differences, I have to make it clear today. Because just like, for example, I was reading today, in Punch newspaper, I think it's there as their front page, that the former governor of Bayelsa State, Mapre Silva, as EFCC has been able to give him back 48 of his properties.
Yeah, he denied that. He said it didn't happen.
Okay. But then to me, I don't think truly, I don't think that is true. Because if that is true, then, the fight against corruption, we are not going to be fair to Nigerians and so forth. So I can tell you clearly, we are going to do everything possible to support Nigeria. And I will pass an advice to my party, let's do what is right.
All right. Mr. Timmy Frank, the National Deputy Publicity Secretary of the APC. Thank you so much for coming on the program.
God bless.
And that's our show for today. Many thanks for being such a great company. On behalf of the team, I'm Shion Kimale. Bye for now.